In this video today, we look at, can spread bets be used for longer term trading? Stay tuned. Hey traders, world, welcome to you. Right, so what do you think of spread bets? You normally think of a short-term day traded instrument, and there's no doubt that they are very powerful for that. The spreads are nice and tight, you've got the margin, you've got the leverage, you've got no overnight costs. If you're day trading, spread betting is perfect. If you're trading currencies, you've got spreads like 0.6 on the euro, 1 point on the Dow, 1 point on the DAX, 1 point on the 40, sometimes less than that. Very, very low cost. You've got your leverage, you haven't got to pay any overnight charges, a perfect day trading vehicle. However, day trading is a different beast to swing trading and longer term trading. You know, day trader, you've got to be glued to the screen, you've got to be sitting there, you've got to be taking the opportunities. There's a time constraint with being glued to the screen. There's an emotional toll that perhaps is a little bit higher with day trading because you've got all the decision making to do and you can be affected by negative emotions much easier potentially than swing trading. Not to say it's not involved in that, but when you're in front of the screen, you're trading, 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 one mistake can be quite damaging and it can be quite easy to dig yourself a big hole. So that being said, can you use spread bets for longer term trading? Now, listen, if you're holding a spread bet for a few days, that's also pretty good because you get paid, you get charged an overnight fee. But again, because you're able to use that leverage and that margin, it's very decent and it's quite favorable. Now, what I'm talking about now is these kind of 6 month trades, 2 month trades, 3 month trades longer. Can you use a spread bet for that? The answer is yes, you can, but you just have to be a little bit sensible about how you're doing it. Let's look at an example. So if you look at the couple of the indices here, the cash indices, which are daily rolling. So effectively you're charged a carrying charge overnight every time you roll it. So about 10 o'clock at night, UK time, you'll get charged a fee. And it's worked out by the interest rate of the asset you're trading. So if you're trading UK, you're trading Germany, you're trading US, or whatever instrument your FX pair you're trading, it'll take the difference of the interest rate as well. But don't have to go into that for now. There's another video where we're going into that in depth. But really what we're looking at is that we just get charged a different fee, basically depending on what we're trading if we have these daily rolling bets. Depends on the position size, etc. So FTSE 100, for example, if we trade the rolling cash, spreads nice and tight, these are normally around a point or less, like I say, you're being charged 3.7% per annum. Could be a little bit more, could be a little bit less, depending on the provider. And then DAX, we've got here 2.6% per annum, and then Dow 5.1% per annum. And that's just charged nightly, so it's divided by 365, depending on my position size. So you can see if you were holding something for, you know, let's say 6 months, you're gonna be charged a reasonable percentage. And that's probably, if you're trading something like the Dow, for example, you know, that's probably not going to be the most efficient way of expressing that trade. If you've got a 6 month trade view, or even if you say a 4 month trade view or 3 month trade view, you know, the rollover costs are going to become quite large over time. When you think about, well, you know, how much do you expect the Dow to move in a year? And I'm sure it can move 10% plus, but over time, you know, you might be restricting yourself a little bit. So the daily rolling cash, or the daily rolling bets, some of them call it, isn't gonna be the most effective way and efficient way of expressing a longer term view. But if you move to futures contracts, and by the way, guys, they're called forwards as well, or they might be called forwards depending on which platform you're using, which broker you're using. Futures or forwards, these are basically far dated expiries. So these will expire. Like the daily rolling cash doesn't expire, just rolls over every day until you close it or you get stopped out or you do something to take the position off. The futures or the forward will expire on that date unless you've got a little setting that says auto rollover, but assume you haven't, they will expire at that date. Now, you don't pay a carrying charge for this. The charge is included in the spread. So the spread is a lot more, I say a lot more, not that much more. It depends on what you're trading, obviously. But for example, I'm filming this in August, by the way, just for reference. So we've got September, we've got October, November, we've got December. So 3 to 4 month exposure time for this. Maybe about 3 months really, because the end of August. It's costing you 2 points to open a December expiry futures contract on the FTSE. So yes, it's double, but if you had that view of longer, it's gonna be far cheaper for you to hold that than it is to pay the 3.7% per annum rollover cost. Then we look at going for all the way to the Dow of the US. Obviously that's gonna be more expensive because it's a higher commission, a higher interest rate, but still 5 points. If you're holding out for 3 months and it's normally 1 point, yes, it's more, but if you think about how much you're saving effectively, it's way more efficient generally to trade these futures expiries if you believe you're looking for something that's going to happen in the future, funnily enough. Now, where you could come unstuck is if you start trading these and you start taking them out after day one or intraday or after day two, because it's going to become costly for you. So if you think that there's opportunity to take the profit early, you might want to stick with these. If you know that, hey, I'm just going to hold this until December or expiry, then these are the way to go. And this is where you can get long-term benefit from spread betting. You know, not many people trade these because, as I say, it's more of a shorter-term vehicle, a lot more interest, day traders are interested in. That's why, you know, the headline spreads are always these ones, the daily rolling cash, but they make the money on the rollover. But if you're going and trading these futures, then you can really get a lot of leverage, you can get a lot of kind of exposure, you get your tax-free wrapper as well with spread betting and not pay an awful lot for it. And the same with this, with Forex, guys. You know, you've got the September expiry is the furthest way out I could go with some of these, but again, it's depending on your broker. Some will offer them, some won't. September expiry, you know, I'm paying not 1.5 points on euro instead of 0.7. I'm paying 2 points on GBP USD instead of 0.9. So I'm paying about double and a bit, but I'm getting much longer. And these are much lower costs. And also it does depend on over the interest rate differential between the pairs you're trading. If you're trading yen, you might actually end up receiving money. But the point is, you know, you could consider doing this for a more efficient way of having a longer term trade. So that's that. That's the kind of the operational side of it. From a mental side of it, just finally, guys, is that I would recommend having an additional broker for those longer term trades. Now, you might not be interested in short term trading anyway. This might be something you want for a longer term, then fine, one broker is okay. But if you want to maybe do a bit of short term trading on the dailies and kind of work in and out and capitalize on some intraday opportunities when you're available to, then that's one account. Have another account, preferably with another broker as well, so you're kind of spreading the risk for your longer term trades. You find the broker that suits you for longer term trades, offer some of these, and use that purely for longer term stuff. The beauty of that is you're not seeing every day the P&L of these when you're logging in to do a little bit of intraday trading. And so you can leave it and not log into it. You don't have to worry about it, because of course, if you've got this for a few months, you don't really care that 2 days are going against you. Whereas 2 days going down, intraday perspective, might be offering you nice short opportunities, and you want to completely separate those and isolate those different strategies and different approaches. So two accounts are even more. I mean, I've got many spread betting accounts with different providers for different reasons, but there's no reason not to ultimately. And so having that separation so that allows you to do that and allows you then a little bit mentally, it's a bit easier when you're logging in and you want to do some day trading to not be influenced by those longer term trades. So guys, can spread bets be used for longer term trading? Yes, they definitely can. If you're a little bit wise and sensible of how you approach it, use these longer term vehicles that are designed for that and perhaps segregate your accounts, you're onto a winner. All right, guys, take care. Keep the risk managed, whatever you're trading, whatever time frame. Bye-bye.